All right. Confession. I kind of already started drawing. The good old ever-present lawn work reared its ugly head, and so I thought, why wait? Basically, what I wanted to do today is I just drew a couple of like basics that I wear all the time, and then I kind of want to use the knowledge of capsule wardrobe, kind of like take what I already have and see what small changes I could make to just feel more like a princess. I have extra paper here. I thought maybe we could do a paper doll effect. That way I can like move the pieces around and see what looks good where. And if that doesn't work, we'll jump over the computer because, you know, Photoshop layers. Doesn't get better than that. Anyway, let's get the, well, not started, but jump into it halfway. This article by Classy Yet Trendy gave you the 5 basics of building a capsule wardrobe. What I kind of like the most about capsule wardrobes and like the science behind it is when I was younger and when I used to shop in like stores, I'd always get gravitated towards like the funnest print, and then I'd never wear it because there was nothing it would go with. So more recently, I've started gravitating towards basics and neutral. If your thrift store is organized by color, basically you just have to go to the boring corner and those are the colors that you want to pick, because then you can couple them with the fun stuff that you already have at home. So, and I kind of just drew some of the basics that I gravitate towards the most. What I should do first is just draw myself, and then I can like start drawing the outfits on a separate piece of paper and cutting them out. So if this is mostly about showcasing the clothes, get out of my screen. I need the pose to kind of reflect that. We can kind of show off the flow of the fabric and the outfits and everything. And then this pose is what we're gonna use as a base for all of the clothes. This hand or arm can kind of just fall at the side. And then this arm we can put on the hip just so we can see it better. I was never someone who really put all that much thought into what I was wearing until more recently. I relapsed real bad. Is it 2 years ago now? Sheesh. And so I didn't really leave the house for almost a year. And so I lived in, you know, comfy clothes and sweatpants, and they don't make you feel the best about yourself. Sure, you're comfortable, but I realized the power of fashion and clothing and how it can make you feel about yourself, and the fact that you have control over what you put on your body, even if you don't have control over everything that's going on in your life. And it became something that I really liked. And so I've been putting more conscious effort into my outfits, even if I'm staying at home, which I'm used to. Alright, I probably should avoid clothes that come off from the body just so that it's easier to overlap. So I'll put on some like tight shorts just so the body shape's a little easier to work with. Alright, so color is gonna be very important with making sure things look good and go together. So I probably could just leave the character white because it doesn't matter. It's more about the clothing, and I don't want to distract from that by accidentally coloring the skin the wrong color. I'm gonna use a 0.5 and I'll just go in and do that then. And then from here we can start adding in the outfits. And when I was looking at this articles, and I've been using that to kind of visualize what I want to do. And like the first thing to do is to start with your base color, which can be either black or navy. I'm a little confused because I feel like my accent color is blue. So does that mean I should pick navy, or does it? I guess it doesn't really matter, but I'm gonna pick black because I just own a lot more black things than navy. So we'll just pick black. And then basically you're allowed, according to this article, 3 tank tops, 3 shirts, 3 long sleeve shirts, 3 pants, 3 shorts, 3 skirts. Basically the fancy number's 3. I don't know if I'm gonna design that many. Depends how fun this ends up being. I have these guys, which are some of my basics that I want to carry over. So I have like a large white t-shirt. I wonder if I could like turn up the brightness on this and use it as a... And basically I just kind of trace it over the body that I've drawn, but on a separate sheet of paper. All right, so there we have a shirt. Look at it all on its own. This one's a little bit tighter. I have like a black t-shirt. So we just trace that out. It's a little longer than that, but I guess you kind of have to follow the rules I made for myself. And that basically covers the 3 tops I'm allowed to have. We have the black one and we have the white one. We'll draw my jacket. I'm gonna do it open so you can see what it's layering. All right, there we have a denim jacket. Super simple, goes with everything. Denim skirt, and we have a pair of pants. If this was Photoshop, I could just copy paste them and change the color. The article lists some examples of things you'd want to have in your capsule wardrobe. And I notice graphic tees is not listed anywhere. It explains why I have a hard time. If I look back at some of the outfits that I came up with, and like tops with laces and buttons and some puffy sleeves, I've tried on some things with puffy sleeves and I don't know, shoulders are not an area like exaggerating, I guess. So I don't feel comfortable in it. This is something I want to lean into slowly. See if it's something that I do really want, because I'm also attracted to other silhouettes here. I like the 1960s silhouette and I like accentuating the waist. It gives off a princessy vibe. I feel like that's a princessy silhouette, kind of like Aurora or something. So yeah, we'll keep these. They have a princessiness, right? Now, following the little article, you're allowed the accent colors, which mine are gonna be blue, so I have some like little blue things I can add. And then you're allowed one or two pattern clothings that can go with the rest. So that way you don't end up with too many patterns that all clash. So I think I wanna do is make sure that this idea is working and go ahead and add line art to these and color and cut them out and see if I can figure out how this works. Try to avoid the areas where it's a little bit lighter in the wash, just to give it a denim-y appearance, so along like the seams. And texture is probably my best friend here. I'm trying to do denims. Voila, look, does it look a little denim-y? There we go, we got a little skirt. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and just do the rest of these. Look how cute! And then I'll be able to like switch them out. So like, oh, I don't wanna wear skirts today. Boom. Shorts. This is fun. Why have I never done this before? I can close it or open it as much as I want. I feel kind of all over the place, even though I feel like I've accomplished something. I don't feel like I'm any closer to the end result. But look at what I can do. I can go, oh, I want to wear black pants with a white shirt. Oh, so cute. So basic. And you can even put a denim jacket on top and look like every other girl on the planet. Got the black one. A whole week's worth of outfits already, and there's like four pieces here. I really like color blocking, like the same color, top and bottom. I feel like it looks very put together. Basically, it's a top. Kind of follows this line. It's cropped, of course it is. And I think it has princess seams, which is probably what gives it that princessy vibe. Straps. It has straps, and it's white. It's more like a cream color, actually. I don't know if that's just from my washing machine. That's what it looks like now, so that's what matters. This is probably gonna look real stupid, but that's why I'm doing it, to find out. Let me cut this out. All right, so like this one, if I stick this on here, would it look bad layered over something like this? I mean, it's a bit childish. What's cool about this is all these colors look good together. I guess that's the point in building a nice basic wardrobe. So you can literally layer anything on top of anything. This gives off a penguin vibe. Wouldn't do that, but like this, if it wasn't as hot as it is today. But I don't know, actually that looks fine too. But like, it's so cute. Look at that. Again, denim on denim, not the smartest. I should cut out some other. I guess this means that something I should look to adding to my wardrobe would be some more bottoms. I was like, I can't really wear the denim jacket with denim shorts. I feel like I got distracted. What was I doing? Oh, we're supposed to like princessify the wardrobe. I think for that I'm gonna need to jump into my sketchbook. According to that article, I am allowed two more sleeveless. So I guess what I would like to do is find some outfits that I can like mix and match with this to just extra princessy. What I would really like is some kind of pinafore. That's one of the first things that I ever sewed for myself. It's kind of just impossible to wear just because it's, I wouldn't say too small, but just impossible to get on. It fits me if you can manage, but it looks kind of like this. A darker, oh, it's actually more of a navy. Is it okay to wear that color with black? Basically, it's like one of those colors with white flowers. So like that's something I can wear on top of those basics, except maybe the black. A pinafore. Oh, I just remembered. White skirt. It's this cute, I think it's, what's it called? Broderie anglaise or something. You know, like the holy, the white cotton stuff that looks like Swiss cheese. floral Swiss cheese. So princessy, but it's white. And I am way too scared to wear white pants because I like to sit outside and sit on random things. And like, when you're wearing a white skirt, you have to be conscious about where you sit. And that's not something that I can be trusted to do. But it's super princessy, so I should probably add it to our little princessy wardrobe. I'm confident enough in this thing to go ahead and actually draw it on top of our model. And I obviously can make it longer. We can definitely see how this looks. Okay, it looks kind of dumb in art form, which is weird because outfits usually look better. But it also has to kind of be wearable, you know? I guess princess maybe isn't the best word to describe the outfits I want. More of like the peasant. You know, like in every Disney movie, the princess has like a more casual outfit. And that's kind of the way I learned to roll. Okay, then we want to do like a nice blue pattern. Right now it looks like Belle's peasant dress. So I want it to be like a ditzy floral pattern. I don't know why it's called ditzy, but that's what it's called. See how it looks with some of the other things we've made. Alright, I wouldn't wear pants with it. Wouldn't wear that skirt with it. Where's my layers, man? And it looks very Belle. I don't think this color is gonna look great with like the black top. It doesn't look terrible, but I don't think I would choose that just because it's less contrast. But you could wear like the tight white shirt or get like a shirred top or something. This is so much better than just drawing them next to each other because it's so much easier to visualize and put them together. So I also cut out our little Swiss cheese skirt just to see how many outfits this would actually go with if I was committed. So like if I'm willing to wear that, I could wear the white top, look very well put together and colorless. I could wear it with this one. I could wear it with this. And the cool thing about this is I can wear this with it. I can wear my jacket and I'm not gonna look too silly. Cute. Can I wear the jacket with this? I don't know if I would. Who cares, right? If you're cold, you're gonna do what you gotta do. I would freaking love to look like a little 1940s investigator and wear a trench coat. One that like cinches at the waist and is very feminine. Sleeves that I'd probably roll up most of the time. I would like it to have a little bit of weight to it. This would be an investment though, so this is far off from something I'm gonna be buying anytime soon. And that's for the point, right? It's to see what would look good and see what's worth investing in and what's not. But I wanna go look like a sleuth and solve crimes and look well put together while doing it. Like in like what color? Like in a this sort of color? No, ooh, little dark. One of these colors, and it would look real good with like the blues and the blacks and the whites. Don't you think? I don't know if it's something that'll ever suit me though, as much as I like seeing it on other people. I just think it's a little too classy for me. I just don't know if I'd ever feel comfortable in it. That's some of those things you never know until you try it on. And obviously things you like change over time. I would also, if I can, have more, what would I want to put into this? Like more stays looking things for layering. I don't know if that's just too much. Or just tops with like square necklines, which is really popular right now, so that might just be too trendy. And I don't really follow trends. And I definitely want more skirts. I do like the button look because it makes it so much more casual. And I like the side button too because it like flattens out your front and it's just super flattering. What would be cute, this won't show in like paper doll format, but if I have a character looking like the other way, that's the face. This is their back. I really like deep plunging back necklines. I think those are so cute. I have this top that I got at the thrift store and I honestly hate it. The pattern is freaking hideous. But I love the way it fits and I love the deep plunging back neckline. It just makes me feel good when I wear it, even though the pattern makes me want to barf. I wear it anyway. I think it's very feminine. I love it. And what else can I say? Look at that. Look at how cute. This video is all over the place, but I hope you're enjoying just coming along with me in my sketchbook. This is kind of just how my brain's working. But like if you use just a normal t-shirt and then like a Jane Austen era stays on top of just a regular t-shirt. The only problem is what do you do with like the rest of the t-shirt that's gonna stick out, right? I love how few items are here and how many outfits I can actually put together. I guess that's the glory of having a capsule wardrobe that complements all each other, you know? Especially, it seems like you can look more put together with a limited wardrobe. Like, we're not even a fraction of what the website allows you to have for your capsule wardrobe. And I feel like probably if I consistently washed my clothes, make it the whole summer with just this, you know? Might get bored, but I wouldn't run out of things to wear. I'm so lost right now. These clothes are more structured than this video, that's for sure. So I think I'm like scared to draw more things because it seems overwhelming and kind of excessive. But the whole point in drawing everything is to see what I would want. So I should just be drawing out everything, whether I end up liking it or not. And I think the best way to do that would be to just move over digitally, because then I can just sketch directly over top of this and I don't have to like use a light box or anything. As cute as it is and how much I love having these little guys, I think I will jump over to digital and I'll meet you over there. So I scanned in that original image that I drew, and then I actually ended up just redrawing all of the items that we drew previously. I didn't take you along in that because I thought it was repetitive, because we literally just did that. Look at all these layers. I have everything grouped by like article of clothing and whatnot, and I think this is actually gonna work way better because now everything's so organized. I actually made two little scrunchies that match the outfit, and then I gave myself little white shoes. Now the other thing I really want to try that I don't own anything of, flowy blouse of some kind that can be like tucked into the pinafore or something like that and give a very like peasant running, frolicking through the fields vibe. So I think that's what I'm gonna add next. We're allowed to have three long sleeve shirts, so I'm gonna count it as one of those. What I do is I just take the little doll, I call me the doll, and I'm gonna lower the opacity so I can just sketch directly on top of that. Go back to the layer I created. So with like a long blouse, I kind of picture it, the top can be kind of loose, kind of like that. Very Keira Knightley, Elizabeth Bennet. And then I assume it'd be a little oversized to get maximum flowiness. And I'm gonna tie it down at the bottom again, just so that if I create layers to put on top of it, it's gonna look like it's cinching it in that way. So I'll just tie it the same way I did with the other blouse, well, shirt, I guess. I think that'll work best. Like, if I stick the pinafore on top, does it make sense? Yeah, look, looks like it's being tucked in. And I'm a big roll up the sleeves kind of individual. Not that I get down to business, but that I actually like rolling up my sleeves. So it's just like a big flowy top. I do actually have, I got it at the thrift store, like a light blue, almost chambray shirt, and it's super soft and flowy, and I think it would work for that. So I'm gonna make two of these. I'll make one in white, so it's like a blouse. And the cool thing about digital is I can just call it Darcy Blouse. And we'll duplicate that. Actually a little darker than that. And you can see how that works with other things. So like this, I assume, would look real cute with the pinafore. Should I put that on top? Eek! This underneath with like for a little extra something. So when I twirl, you see the white underneath. How does it look with, I mean, it's not terrible. It actually works. I think I would like a more fitted long sleeve shirt. This is fun. I recommend it. Do it for yourself. This is great. So, okay, so it says you can add like accent colors. I think I've basically chosen blue as the accent color. It would be nice to add like a burgundy or a red or even a baby pink. And I wouldn't be opposed to adding red. Yeah, because right now everything kind of's blendy. What's like a princessy pant? Oh, we can throw in those shorts, which are also blue. Flowy shorts that they sit around here. They got a waistband. Flap. It kind of looks like a skirt unless you like take really long strides. It's like an incognito shorts. Yeah, about there sounds right. Let's color those in. That's about what they look like. Let's see what it looks like with some things. Now I wouldn't tie this up so high, but it does give me good visualization of how it would look. Don't think I would wear this, but what does this look like with the tank top on top? So it's almost like I should look for like a cardigan, like a white cardigan. According to the article, any new item you add has to go with at least three other items. So this will be like a form-fitting cardigan, I guess. napkin. I roll up all my sleeves, so I'm sure I would do the same thing with this. Okay, that looks way too like 1950s for me. So maybe we'll just leave this black for now and see what it goes with. Eek. Okay, fixed it. That, it's a little preppy for my style though. I think it's leaning more towards preppy than princessy. So maybe if we make it like a different color, what if it was like pink? That's still very preppy. Maybe it just depends how you layer it, because like you could put this underneath. And then you could probably, even if it's cold, throw the jacket on top. Cute! I still think it just can be princess more, you know? Scooping necklines, shirring, gathers, ruffles. They all speak princess to me. Throw something like that in here. Like a longer skirt with buttons. Maybe just like a long version of that. Gathers. And then right at the knee, because anything longer than that, and I feel like I'm not tall, okay? Anything longer than that makes me look really, really small. You know what would also be really cute is right at the bottom if it just had an extra layer. This is too much. I don't think I would wear this. I don't think I would do this. But if I make it shorter, you can wear it on top. And that gives you a fun frilly thing at the bottom. I feel like that definitely like shrinks her. She looks so much smaller now. What about with this guy? It's kind of cute, but I just don't like the skirt at all. So I don't know if it's the way I drew it or if it's just an ugly skirt. It's very like Victorian, like extremely shrunken Victorian. So I'm thinking something like thin straps. We'll do that straight across, square neckline. Make it tight fitting. And then I'm thinking circle skirt from there. I'm not sure what color I would make this. Thinking black, actually. But it would work good with the denim jacket. If I could stick one of these blouses underneath. Oh, I didn't mean to grab the blue one. Okay, that looks cute. That gives me a princess vibe. I think it's the big flowy shirt with the tighter bodice and then the flared skirt. It gives you the hourglass kind of feminine retro figure, but it's also cute. So let's try it with the white. It's a little bit like black and white, but yeah, I think that's why I like the black dress, because the denim jacket looks really good. Obviously it looks good with our tight fitting shirt. Oh, what about the tight fitting black? But it does look cute. Okay, now I want a black dress like this. I just think there's too much black and white. Do you feel the same? I'm gonna duplicate this dress and we'll make it blue. I'll try this blue color. But like I said, this color's so hard to go with stuff. Does it look good with my blue Darcy blouse? Kind of, yeah. Maybe I just need to dive into the world of pink. Cute. Like, it probably won't fit as well as it looks like it will here, but like if I put that on top, kind of just separates the two pieces. Good with white. It's gonna look really good with black. Cute. Pink is great because it looks good with denim. I don't know. I might have to try out pink. I do pink nails all the time, but I don't wear pink. Denim jacket. Yeah. I could also do some stripy shirt or something. Duplicate the baggy top, the loose t-shirt. Call it that because I can't find it when I'm looking for it. I'm gonna duplicate that. We'll put it on her so I can see it. We're gonna add stripes. It's gonna look great with that. Oh, I don't need both of those. It'll look great with this. Oh my gosh. It's gonna look good with this. You know, it's all right. I mean, it's gonna look good, but will it look good with this? It does make that more casual because this is a bit more of like a dressy looking pair of shorts, and that makes it look a little bit more casual. Looks good with that. Yeah, you know it. Looks good with that. Actually, it looks amazing. Looks good with this. A little bit of mime chic. Probably looks good with this. Yep, looks great. Probably looks good with this. Yep, looks awesome. Look at that. It's like such a versatile piece. That's a little bit crazier, but I think I would wear it. Looks amazing. It even looks good with these shorts, even though I would never wear those out in public. I wonder if I should try and bring a cream. Let me just try it with the short sleeve one. So what's beige? It's around here, but I don't want it to be ugly. Beige. It's more pinky. There, that's beige. Except this could blend in with my skin tone and that's not gonna be cute. I see why that will look good with everything.
I mean, just look at it.
Just look at it with everything.
I mean, it kind of goes. It's just like, why not just use white? That's what it says to me. I just don't like color beige.
I wouldn't mind it in a trench coat.
But not that. Yeah, turn that off. Don't like it. Go away. Everything looks like it's got a bite out of it because of that hand.
It looks like to finish off this like capsule wardrobe thing, we just need... Oh, we need one skirt, two tank tops, and a shirt.
Maybe bring more pink into it, so I'm gonna try a pink tank top.
I do really like there's a stays. Illustrate it here for ya. It was kind of straight across the front, like that. And then it had sleeves that came up out from the furthest edge in the armpit. And they're kind of going backwards because in the back, I'm gonna draw through her. They kind of come back down and around, back that way. And then from there, they came around and were tied in the front. I think they wrapped a couple times and then they were tied. But it's a really cool silhouette. It's, so it's like a Regency corset. And I really, really, really like the silhouette of that. So I'm gonna make a tank top. Follows that. Okay, it's not quite what I thought. I'm looking at the actual reference. So it does come, but that's actually a separate piece than the straps. But I'm gonna simplify it and do it the way I explained. Almost like a gunslinger. And then it will have two little ties. I can really simplify it to just one tie.
I think that is such a cute silhouette.
I know. And I think I want to give it a pattern. Let's try it in pink. Digital art's magical like that. What does it look like if we actually layer it on top of the black dress? I know I'm breaking a cardinal sin of putting a stays directly on the skin, but it's a layering piece. I can put it on the top if I want. We're trying to make it work.
Inspired.
Not accurate. We'll call it our Regency tank top. I'm gonna put it on top of the black dress and see what that looks like. Yeah, it doesn't really make any sense. I just wanted to see. So like that's gonna look cute with the jeans. It's gonna look good with these denim shorts, that denim skirt.
Hey,
kind of works. I don't love it quite as much. Let's try giving it a pattern. Maybe a gingham or something. Ooh, even that color is good. Ooh, we're on the wrong layer. Ah, look how cute that is in blue. But does it go with three or more things? I mean, I know it goes with the bottoms, but I mean, like, does it layer with the top? The stripey? That actually kind of goes in a very eclectic way. Darcy blouse still works with the Darcy blouse. Probably won't work with my light wash. What I'm learning is this light wash denim jacket was probably a bad investment because it just doesn't really go with the flow I'm looking for. With the white shirt, it looks very Dorothy. Black shirt, it's a little bit more. What's it? What's the word? Instead of ruby red slippers, I could do a red scrunchie. There we go. Red scrunchie. I like it. I like it a lot. Okay, we need one more tank top. What if I just remake this one? I want them to be thicker. So I'll just pull them as far back as I can. Why am I coloring this in by hand? I didn't do that with any of the other ones. That's actually cute. It's very simple. Maybe just give it top stitching? But yeah, goes with that. Goes with the... Oh, with the black.
Yeah.
The denim with the white. Ooh, with that, it kind of look like Oswald. What does that look like? Why does it look like such a familiar pairing? Is there a character that wears that? What all we're missing? I don't think I need more pants because I do have two shorts. You're allowed to have three of each, but like...
I don't need that.
That's just a lot. Should I draw on the trench coat? Maybe I will.
I'm gonna need reference for that.
I'm not entirely sure what I'd want it to look like. There's so many different variations, but
oh my gosh. Look, I look like a little investigator already.
For some reason there's some kind of weird flap here. Don't know what that's called or for. Ah, I've always wanted a little trench coat.
Look, I'm like instantly Nancy Drew.
About to solve all your crimes and misdemeanors.
I just can't actually see me putting it on as much as I love the way it looks.
A little trench coat. Ah, looks good with everything. Look, cute, double cute, extra cute, and extra cute. Also cute, cute, cute. Ah, so cute.
Everything goes with everything.
Something I was doing in my sketchbook was like taking a famous outfit from like a famous character and then like changing it up into more of a wardrobe. That's something I've just been kind of doing on my own. So that might be something fun to do. Let me know if you'd be interested in that. This was so much fun. Maybe I didn't accomplish my goal of making it princessy, but I did actually create a wardrobe that works together. That's really cool. Patted it, like, good job.
Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys all next week, and I hope you have a delicious evening full of waffles.
Bye!